When we see small self-managed condominium associations, many times there is one owner who's retired or who works from home who takes on the lion's share of the administration responsibilities, shows up when the contractors appear, manages projects because he or she is on site, and sometimes they seek compensation. The rule is simple. Board members cannot be compensated unless that is authorized by the bylaws. But the more interesting issue is whether or not the board who doesn't compensate the board member as a board member, but decides to enter in a contract with that board member for certain services on an hourly basis or a monthly basis. In such situations, there could be a conflict of interest. That means under the Illinois Condominium Property Act, the board, after it makes its decision, must notify the owners in writing of the potential conflict, and the owners have a series of procedures they can institute to reject the actual decision. In addition to the potential conflict of interest, an association should also consider, is this person insured in case they make a mistake or they injure themselves on the property? Because now they're not quite acting in the capacity of a board member, they're acting in the capacity of a contractor to the extent there's a contract for services on a time basis.